Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad with that. Thank you for the season of Christmas, the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And thank you, dear God, for these family and friends, but mostly these children, these young people, who have dedicated their times and their lives to come and represent you here this morning. Bless them. Take away anything that would hinder a successful drama presentation this morning. Bless it, God, and may you receive glory from it. Yes, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. This year's drama is called Dateline J.P.K, and we'd like you to give them a nice warm hand clap as we encourage the kids this morning.
J.P.K. We have a special report from Bethlehem.
Thank you, Dave. This just in. A report has been made that there has been unusual events surrounding the city of Bethlehem, New Jerusalem. According to our Israeli correspondent, Jane, there has been news related to angel sightings and something about a special king being born for the Jews. Jane, are you with us?
Yes, Denise, I'm here.
What is going on in Bethlehem? There seems to be a lot of commotion.
Well, Dave, I'm receiving breaking news concerning the Jewish people and their laws. Apparently, their long-awaited king, whom they call their Messiah, was born last night, and that some shepherd men were visited by an angel in and led to the actual site of the birth, which was, if you can believe this, a stable.
Did you say a stable?
I sure did, Denise. Apparently, with the town being crowded with people to pay their taxes, there is no room for a woman to stay in an inn.
How awful to have a baby in a stable. And did you say this baby was supposed to be the great king that the Jewish people have been waiting for?
That is correct, Dave. Unfortunately, that's all the information I have for now, but here comes some townspeople. Let me get first-hand information from them. DateLine J.P.K. News. I was wondering if you had any information about the Messiah being born.
There's a lot of commotion. I'm from Nazareth here to pay taxes. No person shall be saying that they were visited by an angel until the Messiah has been born.
What's a Messiah?
The Savior of the world God promised his people a long time ago.
The Savior of the world? Really? Like some superhero or something?
Well, to fully understand our Jewish customs and history, you have to read a history book called the Old Testament. Everything is explained in these writings. I'm sorry, I must go. You should go talk to the innkeeper.
Who is this innkeeper, Jane?
I heard he was the owner of the inn where that couple stayed the night.
Well, it sounds like we need to find that innkeeper to find more information about this amazing story.
Hello, my name is Jane, and I'm a news reporter with Dateline J.P.K. News. Are you the owner of this inn?
Yes, may I help you?
Yes, I was told a young couple who were expecting a baby came here last night to spend the night. Are they here?
No, they are not here. I had to turn them away because there's no room left in my inn. I told them they're more than welcome to stay in the stable.
With the animals? A woman is expecting a baby, and you tell her to sleep with the animals. Are you kidding me?
I wish I were. I feel terrible, but there's absolutely no room left in my inn. I have a wife and all, so of course I had to get one for me too.
Back to you, Dave.
We must go for a break. Please stay tuned to learn more about this special report coming to you live from your most trustworthy news team here at Dateline, J.P.K.
Thank you.
tuning in for the first time tonight, we are reporting live with a very special report from Bethlehem concerning the birth of a long-awaited king for the Jewish people.
Thank you, Denise. Let's go back to Jane, who is reporting from Bethlehem. Jane, are you still with us?
Yes, Dave, I'm here.
Can you tell us any more information about this amazing story?
Well, Denise, there is still a lot of commotion going around in the area. I'm seeing lots of people walking up and down the streets. Wait a minute, I hear something. Sounds like yelling?
We've seen him! We've seen him!
We've seen him!
Who, the Messiah?
Yes, our King, our Savior. He is here! He is here!
But how do you know that this is the Messiah people have been waiting for?
Because an angel from heaven visited us while we were watching our sheep and told us the birth of our Savior.
An angel? Really? Like with feathers and wings and everything?
Yes, we cannot believe our eyes, but the angel is real.
And the angel told us where to look, and we found him! We found him!
Will you take me to see him?
Yes, follow us. Three kings from the Orient, they came to bring gifts to the king.
Excuse me, sir?
Yes, may we help you?
Yes, my name is Jane, and I'm a news reporter with DateLine J.P.K. News. I was wondering if I can ask you some questions about the so-called Messiah being born.
But yes, what is your question?
Well, where did you hear about the birth, and where did you know where to look for him?
Not only were we wise kings, we are also astrologers who study the stars.
We've studied the prophets' writings concerning the birth of the Messiah, and in those writings, the prophets tell us to look for a special kind of star that will only be seen during the time of the Savior's birth. We were told this special star would be our sign.
Now we are finally here to worship our Savior and bring him gifts.
I want to see him for myself. I'm going to follow you guys.
Torn all apart. How
wise kings from the east here to worship our Savior and bring him gifts. I offer him frankincense.
I offer him gold. And I offer him myrrh. Thank you, you're all very kind.
I'm so very sorry for intruding, but my name is Jim, and I'm a news reporter with Dateline, J.P.K. News. I heard about the birth of your son, the Messiah, and I just had to come see for myself. Would you mind if I ask you his name?
His name is Jesus, the Savior of the world.
The greatest miracle of all, the birth of Jesus.
That's right, Dave. We have witnessed a miracle. The Savior of the world was born of a virgin named Mary, and this little baby will save the world from their sin.
This is David and Denise wrapping up our special report for the evening. Thank you for watching Dateline JPK, and I pray that you will let Jesus be your Messiah and tell the world that Jesus lives. Thank you, and good night.
Bye.
Mr. Vayner, I gotta tell you and John, with all the stressfulness of practices and losing your voice and everything, is it not worth it, folks?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Give the Lord another hand clap. He's just a fantastic job. Hallelujah. Vayner, I want you to go back and get what you have to get. We have some presentations to give to these children. They deserve it. They have done such a wonderful, wonderful job. Don't you see the growth in our kids over from last year to this year? Hallelujah. I'll tell you one, they like John to come down here too, John. I like you, unless you have to run something up there, brother. You're always working. Devana always has John working. But come over here, John. And these props, you know, something of this magnitude takes a lot of helpers, right? A lot of adults, your parents coming out, bringing your kids out, sacrificing, sitting in the parking lot during practice times. Sacrificing your time, even some of these props take time to work, but man, these kids nailed it, home run out of the park, man. They represented God well. Hallelujah. We like Lorraine and Lorraine and Gil Near to come here. Where are you? Come up here. Lorraine and Gil, they support this church. They're a food pantry, but they always are blessing this church, and they have been big. You guys don't know it, to our children's ministry and youth ministry. They're always giving goodies and snacks and just gifts. They're always blessing the children. They feel connected with them to a degree. So Lorraine, we like, you know, on behalf of Joy Kids, we like to thank you and Gil very much for all that you do for the children's ministry, you and Gil both. And we like you, I know you want to present one of the kids. Lorraine, we like to present to the kids, her and Gil, and we like to go ahead and let her do that.
Liliana? My voice is gone, guys. Sorry. Liliana? Gideon? Jesse. John Aaron. Ashley. Elijah. Jacob. Christian. Jesse. Emily. Alex, did I call you? Does everybody have one? Does everybody have a stocking? Okay. Can you guys say thank you? This is from, yes.
Thank you.
And Mr. Gill. Okay, thank you guys.
Ms. Devana has for you kids here for doing such a great job. It's got a beautiful, she said, tell them what it looks like. Pastor, who can't see, tell them what it looks like. It's got a nice cross and a Bible in the front of it. And in the back of it, it's engraved, what's it say to me? 2014 Joy Kids Christmas Musical. Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, wow.
Yes. These kids have worked so hard on this play, and I'm so very proud of them. They did an awesome job. And I want to say thank you to all my workers that have helped me. I can't name them all. John and Stephen in the back, Terry and Becca, and all the parents that have helped me with the children and the costumes. So I'm going to call your name up. I'm going to call your name up. When I call your name, come over to Pastor Eddie, and he's going to put a medallion on you, okay? So Xavier was wise man number one. He was head of the wise men. Come on, Xavier. Xavier learned all the lines to all three of the wise men parts because we were fading in and out of wise men. We'd have some come and then not come back to practice. And so this little guy did an exceptional job of learning all the lines. We have Miss Brandy, one of our holy angels. Thank you, Brandy. And we have Jessie, who played Mary, the mother of Jesus. Good job, Jessie. This is my nephew, Alex Foraker. He came all the way from White Springs, Florida, to fill in for us to be wise man number three. Liliana, our sheep. Come on, baby. Isn't she adorable? Sophia, our other holy angel. Good job, Sophia. Josiah, who was Joseph. Come on, Josiah. Good job, baby. Good job. Adriana, who was anchorman number two, also known as Denise. Awesome job, Adriana. John Aaron, who played anchorman number one, also known as Dave. Good job, John Aaron. Elijah, our cow. Good job, Elijah. Also, Elijah knew all the words to the song. And even though his little voice couldn't carry like the older ones, he sang every word. He was a good singer. Gideon, shepherd number two. Good job, Gideon. Awesome. Jacob, shepherd number three. Good job, Jacob. He's our youngest in the play. He did an awesome job. Janiyah, townsperson number one. Come on, Janiyah. Good job, baby. We have Christian back there. Come on, Christian. Wise man number two. Good job, Christian. Christian had to miss some practices because of being very, very sick, and he did such an excellent job. Good job, Christian. Ashley, she was two roles. She was our townsperson, our taxpayer, and our star. Good job, Ashley. We have the old stingy innkeeper. Come on, Nate. I want you guys to know that Nate added to his lines the line of Well, I have a wife and we need a room for ourselves. He added that. Good job, Nate. We have Genesis who played two roles, cameraman number one and our donkey. Good job, Genesis. PJ, come on, head shepherd. This is our head shepherd. He had to learn the lines of another shepherd who didn't make it today, and he did an awesome job. Summer was, she was cameraman number two, and she was also married, did you know, solo. Good job, Summer. And we have Emily. She was our Israeli correspondent and pretty much the star of the play. She learned all those lines and also remembered to put the microphone in everybody's face so we could hear them. Good job, Emily. Job well done. Did I miss anybody? Everybody? Okay. All right. I have one more thing I had told the children. I had told the children that during the play practice, whoever was the best behaved for every practice, who showed up to every practice, was going to get an extra special surprise. And there were two people in the, there was five or six in the running. And then last night it got narrowed down to just a few. Yeah. It was a very, very hard decision. Guys, you all did excellent and wonderful. But I did tell you I was going to pick that one person who did the best at behaving and listening. Jacob just found that he had candy. He's excited. And so this gift, this is a $25 gift card to Walmart for them to spend on whatever their little hearts desire. And it's a thank you for listening to Miss Devana and obeying me and coming to practice. And this card goes to Ashley. That was a tough decision because we had so many that were running very close.
I was saying, John was saying, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Before we dismiss in prayer, she gave out her reward, but we have something for Devana and John. Don't you believe they are worthy? Yeah. You know, I will say this, I mean, they're both awesome. I mean, we have the privilege of knowing them a little longer than you have, guys, and we just love them. They're just awesome. But, you know, we know what Devana does. You see her up here, you know what she does. But I tell you, to me, a person that I, and then because I'm being biased, you know, they always say, like, in politics, behind every great man, there's even a greater woman. But the same thing she said, behind every great woman, there's even a greater man. He does great work, man, behind the scenes. He gives all these props and all the power techniques. He's Johnny on the spot. John, you two guys work great together. And on behalf of Joy and Praise, we want to show you some appreciation. Both of you, stand up here, please. We got a little gift for you, Devana, for you, for appreciation for this play, and also one for you, John. Then give them a hand clap for appreciation. Please stand with me. We have cookies.